Hello everyone, I'm Samuel from Just Gaming for Fun, and welcome back to 30 Minutes to Impress, a series where I show the opening 30 minutes of any game and then share my thoughts on it and decide if it impressed me enough to feel the game is worth playing past the opening 30 minutes. For a game to impress me, it needs to at least hit one or more of these boxes. 1. Fun gameplay. 2. Likable characters. 3. An interesting world. And 4. A good story. In the last episode, I covered Alice Madness Returns for the PS3. If you haven't seen it, I'll leave a link down in the description and comments. I recommend you check that video out after watching this episode. Speaking of today's episode, I'll be playing Persona 5 for the PS3. It's available for the PS4 as well, but I wanted the PS3 original. Now, of course, not every episode will feature a PS3 game, but I just really wanted to play Persona 5, so that's what it's going to be. Now, I've never played Persona 5 or any other Persona before, but I've seen and heard a lot of positives about it, so I really wanted to check it out. I don't know what to expect because my only real experience with JRPGs is with Final Fantasy and the occasional other JRPG here and there. So, with that being said, let's cut out the chit-chat and let's jump into the world of Persona 5 for the PS3. Will it impress or depress? Let's find out.
この物語はフィクションである。作中の以上のことに同意した者にのみ、このゲームに参加する権利がある。確かに受けたまわった。今世界はあるべき姿にあらず、歪みに満ち、もはや破滅は免れない。定めに抗い、変革を望む者。それは時にトリックスターとも呼ばれた。何時トリックスターよ。今こそこの世の歪みの深淵に立ち向かうがいい。
すぐに始末しろ。
よし、逃走開始だ。
行くしかない。
慌てないで、今なら逃げられる。
アタッシュケースはこっちで回収しとくわ。
なんだ。とにかくこっちのことは心配無用だ。それにしてもさっき大勢の客の上であえて姿を晒したのはうまい行動だった。さすがはジョーカーだ。
あそこだ。
逃げて。よし、敵の目がジョーカーに集まってる。こっちはうまく。
やっちゃってジョーカ
じゃない、見つけて殺せ。
どうしたの？そこが出口のはずだよ。
これは
そういうことか。あの騒ぎじゃ下の階はほら全部塞がってるわね。ねえ、行ける？
あそこだ。逃げ場はないぞ。
じゃあな。
かっこいいまねしてくれるね。
無茶なんだから、ったく。
とはな、恨むなら仲間を恨め。お前は売られたんだ。
容疑者現人、現行犯逮捕。
薬が効きすぎたか。起こせ。 寝るな。まだわからないのか。無駄なんだよ。素直になれ。それともお注射もう一本行くか。あ、カメラが気になるか。まさか可視化法なのに期待してるのか。そこまでバカじゃないか。おかげで我々も精一杯働けるってわけだ。異謀に脅迫、名誉毀損、狂気準備集合罪、本当は殺しもだろう。フルコースだな。これだけやった主犯がこんなガキとは。しかも随分楽しそうだったな。え？図に乗るなよ。ここに名前を書け。お前名義の自白調書だ。そうか、サインは手がなきゃできないが、足くらいなくても俺は困らんぞ。無事に出られるなんて思うなよ。嫌ってほど分からせてやる。やったことには責任がつきまとうってことをな。
失礼。この先は。
地検特捜部の新島です。
検察、何の用です？
いいから通して。緊急です。被疑者にどうしても確かめたいことが。
新島さん、もうあんたに指揮権はないはずだ。それに、
新島再検事ですか。たった今、お宅の部長さんから電話があった。さっさと済ませてくれ。正直、迷惑なんだよ。
やれやれ、待機を言い渡したはずだがな。
責任者の私が尋問も許可されないんですか。
そう言われちゃかなわんから、電話をしてやった。
自分で確かめるまで納得できません。これは私の仕事です。
健闘を祈るよ。あまり期待はしてないがね。
ああ、検事さん、大事なことを言い忘れた。時間を切らせてもらうよ。長話は許可できない。あんたのためだよ。何しろ奴の手口は不明なんだ。会って話すだけでも安全とは言えない。
わかりました。君だったとはね。もう一度、今度は私の質問に答えてもらうわ。 あの連中。聞こえてる？いろいろあったようね。きっとここでは何でも起きるわ。私じゃ止められない。だから正直に答えて。それに私も時間がないの。目的は何だったの？なぜこんな大事件を引き起こしたの？私は最初からいたずらだとは思ってなかったわ。で、手口がわからなかったから。裁判に使えるかは問題じゃない。知る必要があるの。これは私の仕事なんだから。まともに喋れるよね。君はいつどこであの世界のことを知ったの？他人の心なんて一体どうやったら盗めるの？さあ話しなさい、すべてをね。
あなたは囚われ、あらかじめ未来を閉ざされた運命の囚われ。これは極めて理不尽なゲーム。勝機はほぼないに等しい。しかしこの声が届いているということは、まだ可能性は残っているはず。お願いです、このゲームに打ち勝ち、世界を救って。逆転の鍵は絆の記憶、仲間と掴んだ起死回生の真実。全ては半年前、ゲームが始まったあの日。どうか思い出して、あなたと世界の未来の。
本日はご利用いただきまして誠にありがとうございました。まもなく渋谷終点です。地下鉄線ご利用のお客様はお乗り換えです。 Thank you for using this line.
このガキ、訴えてやる。
本当？
暴走とか。
本当だって。
いきなり人間が？冗談でしょ？あんた本当にオカルト話好きだよね。
感じはしてるんですけれども。
明日の課題超難しい。
バスがお客を乗せたまま逆走ですからね。公共の交通機関なのに。これじゃ市民は安心して暮らせませんよ。
怖えな。
どうなってんのかしら。この前もあったじゃない。
ねえ、たては真珠の養殖に使う貝の名前。あ、そうか。今日って言ってたな。
ごちそうさん、お代置いとくよ。
毎度。
この店は裏路地だし、車突っ込んだりはしなさそうだね。
突っ込む？
いや、変な暴走事故続いてるじゃない。この辺でも起きなきゃいいなってね。
興味ないな。
また来るよ。
コーヒー一杯で4時間かよ。お前が。さくら宗次郎だ。1年間お前を預かることになってる。どんな悪ガキが来るかと思ったらお前がね。聞いてるか。
うちの客とお前の親が知り合いで。まあいいか、ついてこい。お前の部屋だ。寝床のシーツくらいはくれてやるよ。ん？何か言いたそうだな。あとは自分で片付けろ。店閉めたら俺は引き上げる。夜は一人になるが、悪さすんなよ。騒いだら放り出すぞ。さてと、一応事情は聞いてるよ。確か男に言い寄られてる女をかばったら、男が怪我して訴えられただっけか。大人相手に余計なことをするからだ。怪我させたのは事実なんだろ。で、前歴がついたお前はあえて地元の高校を退学処分。裁判所の指導で転校転居を迫られ、両親もそれを承諾と。要は厄介払いされてここへ来たわけだ。余計なことは言うなよ。これでも客商売だからな。向こう一年はおとなしく暮らせ。何も起こさなきゃ観察も解ける。お前な、保護観察期間だよ。来年の春までだったよな。だから一年の約束なんだろ。問題起こせば少年院送りだぞ。明日囚人に行くからな。囚人学園高校、てめえで通う学校だろうがよ。先生方に挨拶参りだ。おめえみたいなのが編入できるとこそうそうねえんだからな。せっかくの日曜だってのによ。ああ、届いたお前の荷物置いといたからな。マジかよ。
通報しやがった。車に乗れ。お前らのような無能な連中は黙って俺の舵取りに従え。おい、何見てんだ。向こうに行け。見せ物じゃねえんだ。失せろか。
And damn, time is up already. I was really getting into it right there. But anyways, that was the first 30 minutes of Persona 5 for the PS3. So now let me share my opinion on what I thought. First off, let me state that yes, you can play Persona 5 in English, but I chose to download the free Japanese audio file from PSN because I just prefer Japanese voice acting for animes, so the same goes for anime-style video games. It's just a personal preference. I honestly just can't stand the voices of English anime actors. But if you want to play in English, you can. The choice is there. First off, the anime visuals are beautiful for the cutscenes and in-game graphics. At first, it honestly felt like I was watching an anime. Right off the bat, I can tell Persona 5's HUD/display graphics are very unique. I've never seen anything quite like it. I definitely could see how some people might not like it because it tends to clutter the screen, and at first I was worried about that myself, but I quickly learned to love its personal charm and it didn't bother me. Now, I admit I know nothing about Shin Megami Tensei or Persona, so I have no idea if the games are connected or just in the same universe, or if it just shares some traits in their universe like Final Fantasy does. So I don't know if characters cross over between games or anything like that, or if all these characters are purely unique to Persona 5. I have no idea because I never played the other games. But what I can say is I love the character design of Joker. He looks pretty damn badass, and I'm not surprised why a lot of girls love Joker. He is a very attractive anime character, but at the same time, he sort of reminds me of Tuxedo Mask from Sailor Moon. Am I the only one who thought that? Let me know in the comments. Now, in the entirety of the first 30 minutes, I only experienced one battle, and that kind of sucks, especially for me because my favorite part of JRPGs, or any game for that matter, is the combat. My first experience with a JRPG was the masterpiece that is Final Fantasy VII for the PS1, and I can tell you I could have plenty of battles within the first 30 minutes of that game. So this was a bit disappointing, simply because one short battle isn't enough for me to fully gauge how the combat is. But what I will say is that I did really enjoy it, if that means anything at all. So I'm at least looking forward to more combat. The combat wasn't boring or anything like that, so that's a plus. The battle menu did seem a little confusing and cluttered, but I'm sure once I get to experience a few more battles, it won't be so intimidating to a first-time player like myself. Okay, I'm just going to say this, I'm honestly not a fan of the music that was playing all throughout the opening scene with Joker, but at the same time, I don't think it would bother me enough to make me stop playing. But I do hope the music does improve as the game goes on. I wouldn't mind some pumping battle music reminiscent to the likes of Final Fantasy. That's just what I'm used to. That's the kind of music I like in JRPGs. So hopefully it doesn't stay the way it is here, but I could be wrong. It could be that kind of music the entire game. I don't know. Movement through the world feels pretty damn good. It feels like a living place, especially in the real world where I had to ask for locations and then find where to go. I've heard there's a lot to do outside of your typical JRPG tasks, like a lot of normal day life stuff or even high school activities and just random stuff like that. And that does sound odd to me, because usually I would never want to do stuff like that in a video game, because I lived that kind of life already before in real life. So it's not something I really want to do in a video game, but I'm fully prepared to give it a fair shot and try to truly let myself get immersed into Persona 5's world. If anything, it will be the first time I experience anything like this in a game before. So that's pretty exciting. But I'm honestly confused how the real world and this other world will connect, but obviously that should be corrected the more I play. So to me, Persona 5 feels like a double-edged sword for first-time players, because it has an interesting setup. But on the other hand, I could see how this would scare people away as well, because it feels like nothing I've ever played before. And maybe this is not true, but I feel I would understand what's going on better if I played the past Persona games. So from my perspective, it's not really a good thing that first-time players can't just jump right into the game without having to worry about what came before. Now, I don't know if that's true. Maybe these games are completely separated, I don't know. But if it's not, then that becomes a barrier for new players. Again, going back to Final Fantasy, you can start at any entry without worrying about what came before. But please don't take this as I'm hating on the game. On the contrary, it's like nothing I've ever played before, and thus it feels fresh and exciting. Back in the day, this is the kind of game I would never have given a shot. But being older allows me to be more open-minded nowadays. And when it comes to gameplay, presentation, graphics, and the world, it all looks fantastic. It just looks like a work of beauty. So gameplay is different from what I'm used to, but it has me intrigued, and the first battle I was able to play was pretty fun. So I'm excited to see how the battle advances moving forward. Since I haven't met a whole lot of characters yet, I can't really decide if the game has great characters, but what I can say is that now I am a fan of Joker. I wasn't excited when he was announced for Smash Ultimate, but now I really want to go back to Smash Ultimate and download Joker. I think I get the appeal now. The world of Persona 5 is confusing, but damn does it have a lot of charm and personality. And it sure as hell got me excited to get lost in this world. And the start of the story is pretty interesting, especially the bullshit on how Joker saves a woman from getting raped, but then he gets sued because he hurt the rapist. Now that's some straight up bullshit right there, but damn, that is an interesting start to a game. Overall, I really liked what I played so far of Persona 5. It truly is like nothing I've ever played before. And I'm hating myself for not jumping onto Persona 5 sooner. It definitely hits all my boxes, and I can say with the most certainty that Persona 5 is worth playing past the opening 30 minutes. But it's not just about what I think. What did you think about Persona 5? Did the opening 30 minutes catch your interest or not? Let me know in the comments, and if you have played and beaten it before, let me know if I'm making the right choice to keep playing Persona 5. Am I in for an awesome ride and experience? I sure as hell hope so. Anyways, if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, and if you like this format, by all means, subscribe to my channel. And if there are any modern or retro games you want to see appear on 30 Minutes to Impress, let me know in the comments as well. I'm open to all suggestions, and if you want to see what I'm up to or anything like that, you can always follow me on Twitter, and my link will be in the description. So, until next time, stay safe out there, and keep on gaming, gamers.